Every action and thought that we have happens because of our nervous system. Without it, we wouldn't be what we are, an incredibly complex and intelligent organism. But how does it work? Let's explore what we know about the nervous system. To put it simply, the nervous system is the part of an animal's body who thinks and coordinates actions. All animals have a nervous system, except super simple ones like sea sponges. The nervous system is composed of two major parts, the central nervous system located in the brain and in the spinal cord, and the peripheral nervous system located all over the rest of the body. The central nervous system is like the mission control center of the body. It analyzes things and decides what to do. It then sends a signal to the peripheral nervous system, who takes action by stimulating the appropriate muscle or gland. This motor division of the peripheral nervous system can either be somatic, like the contraction of a leg, or autonomic, like the contraction of the heart. In parallel, the sensory division of the peripheral nervous system detects stimuli with the help of sensory neurons and sends signals to the central nervous system, which then decides whether or not an action should be taken. If the stimuli indicate that the body is in danger, for instance a hen on a hot stove, the signal only passes through the spinal cord and is immediately sent to the muscles. These reflexes happen in a fraction of a second. However, if the body isn't in direct danger, the signal passes through the spinal cord and goes to the brain, which eventually decides what to do. But what is the nervous system made of? It is composed of nervous tissues. They contain neurons that transmit messages and glial cells that support and protect neurons. There are five types of sensory neurons: thermoreceptors, which react to changes in temperature; photoreceptors, which react to light; chemoreceptors, which react to chemicals; mechanoreceptors, which react to pressure, touch, and vibration; and finally, nociceptors, which indicate pain. Nociceptors are special neurons that only fire up when a certain amount of pain is detected. However, when cells are damaged, they release chemicals that lower the pain threshold. This prevents the body from aggravating the injury. But due to a rare genetic disease, some people can't feel pain. Although it might seem nice to feel no pain, this condition is actually very dangerous because serious injuries can easily occur. But how do neurons transmit messages? They first receive an electrical stimuli in their dendrites. Then, this signal travels the axon before going to the axon terminal. Finally, it travels a synapse, the junction between two neurons, and arrives in the dendrite of another neuron. This process is then repeated by millions of interconnected neurons until the signal reaches its destination. However, there are two types of synapses. Electrical synapses transmit the electrical impulse without changing it. This process is fast but imprecise. This is why it is used in the peripheral nervous system to accomplish autonomic actions. On the other hand, chemical synapses can amplify or modify the electrical impulse, which allows more complex messages to be transmitted. Although this process is slower, it is more precise. This is why it is used in the central nervous system and in certain parts of the peripheral nervous system. Thus, when a signal travels the axon, special molecules called neurotransmitters are released. They then temporarily bind to receptors on the receiving neuron, which creates an electrical impulse. After a certain time, the neurotransmitters release from the receptors. Part of them are chemically destroyed by enzymes, while others return to the initial neuron and are recycled. Each type of neurotransmitter has a specific function, but there are two major kinds of neurotransmitters in balance. Excitatory ones stimulate neurons, while inhibitory ones calm them. As of today, about 50 different neurotransmitters have been identified in humans. Here are the main ones. Epinephrine, also known as adrenaline, and norepinephrine, also known as noradrenaline, are both released during moment of high stress. They are part of the fight or flight response, which gives the body the energy it needs to either fight the danger or flee. Adrenaline opens the lungs and increases the blood flow, which gives extra energy to the muscles, while norepinephrine increases the alertness and concentration. As to glucagon, it is constantly released in the brain. It plays an important role in the development of neural pathways, which are responsible for learning and memory. Acetylcholine is present all over the body. It not only triggers muscle contraction and stimulates glands, but it is also believed to play a role in memory and attention. Endorphins are a class of neurotransmitters that are released during physical exercise, sex, or when the body is seriously injured. They create a feeling of euphoria that reduces pain. Although serotonin is constantly present in the brain, physical exercise increases the release of this neurotransmitter. Serotonin plays an important role in the digestion of food and the regulation of sleep cycles, along with melatonin. It also makes us happy as it creates a general feeling of well-being. Gamma-aminobutyric acid is a neurotransmitter that is constantly released in the brain. It calms excited neurons and inhibits the release of neurotransmitters, which relaxes the body and helps to stay mentally focused. Dopamine is a special neurotransmitter that is considered to be both excitatory and inhibitory. It is released during activities essential to the survival of the species, such as eating or having sex, and it creates an intense feeling of pleasure and satisfaction. It is also believed to play a role in motivation and attention. So the nervous system is an essential part of our body. It is incredibly complex, and a lot about it is yet to be understood.